There's always a few rookies that were selected outside of the top five that end up being pleasant surprises for the teams that drafted them. Usually with any draft, the top five is going to be theoretically where the top end talent is. This year, it's guys like Evan Mobley, Cade Cunningham, and Scotty Barnes that are showing up as the primary top three. But in a redraft, I can't imagine as many teams passing up on Franz Wagner as there were. Wagner ended up being selected 8th overall by the Orlando Magic, their second top 10 pick in the 2021 NBA draft. They selected Jalen Suggs with the 5th overall pick, and while I do still think Suggs has a good amount of potential and will likely develop into a very good NBA player, it's pretty clear that Franz Wagner has been the best rookie on the Orlando Magic this year. But as with any rookie, the question is always, how much are they going to improve? What's Wagner's upside? In this video, we're going to try and answer those questions and talk about what makes Franz Wagner so great and why I think he's going to be a huge part of the Orlando Magic's rebuild. We're going to cover a lot in this video, so be sure to stick around until the end so that you don't miss anything. And hit that subscribe button if you enjoy the video. We're almost to 4,000 subscribers, so let's try to hit that by the end of the year. Let's get right into it. Franz Wagner came out of Berlin, Germany, and he had a background in playing professional basketball overseas. He was a four-star recruit coming out of high school, and he would play two seasons at Michigan. He had a pretty solid college career, particularly in his sophomore season where he would average 12.5 points and 6.5 rebounds while shooting 48% from the field and 34% from three. Scouts typically had him mocked as a lottery pick pretty much all around, going anywhere from the 9th to the 12th pick. He wasn't without criticism heading into the draft, with scouts having questions about his shot creation ability, his foot speed, his ability to hit his jump shots, and even his rebounding ability. And while some of these criticisms were definitely fair, he's also proved a lot of them wrong. At a glance, Wagner is putting up some really solid numbers for a rookie, with 15.6 points, 4.7 rebounds, and 2.7 assists per game. His efficiency is pretty solid as well, shooting 45% from the field and 36% on three-pointers. But the last 15-game stretch for Wagner, to me, has been what has proven to me that he's going to be more than just a role player, and he actually has the potential to be a star. Over the last 15 games of the season, Franz Wagner is averaging 19.5 points and 5.5 rebounds per game on 55.8% true shooting. These would be the best scoring numbers by any rookie this season. This is one of the reasons why Franz Wagner jumped up to number one in the NBA's Rookie of the Year ladder in the most recent update. He has the most 20-point games of any rookie this season, with 8 20-point games so far, and 6 of those 20-point games came within the month of December. There is so much to like about Wagner's game, and I want to start off talking about his scoring. He's a 6'9" small forward, but he really doesn't move like it. He's got a really tight handle for how big he is, and he's actually really good at using his first step to blow by defenders and muscle his way to the rim. Now look at this play here. He's got essentially three guys guarding him in Sadiq Bey, Isaiah Stewart, and Killian Hayes. Wagner uses his body to keep Bey off of him while getting some space away from Hayes. He sees Carter Jr. is holding off Stewart, and Wagner uses his crafty handle and that semi-screen by Carter to get an easy shot at the rim. Here, he's going up against Jaden McDaniels, who honestly has been a pretty great defender this year. Wagner hits him with the behind the back and quickly changes directions and then uses his big frame to get some space from McDaniels for the tough bucket. He looks really unbothered when operating with the ball in his hands, which is something that's not very common for guys of his size. And while he's not the most effective isolation scorer right now, I do think that's an area of his game that's going to continue to improve as he gets more comfortable in the NBA. His ability to create space is there. It's just now a matter of getting his shot to fall. Scouts were really worried about his quickness and ball handling ability, but honestly, his speed and ability to keep defenders guessing looks pretty great to me so far. If he gets inside the arc and you give him even a little bit of space, he's gonna get whatever look he wants at the rim. He's really just too big, having that 6'10 frame and 7-foot wingspan. So regardless of how well you're contesting his shot, he's gonna be able to get it off over you. When he gets to the rim, he's otherwise pretty effective, at least by rookie standards. He's shooting 59% at the rim this season, which isn't too far off from the league average of 64%, so that's a really good sign of that area of his game. He literally has not missed a single dunk this year, and when he gets to the rim and he's open, you can bet that it's probably going to go down with a slam. What's really impressive about his game around the rim is how he operates as a cutter. He is ridiculously intelligent at knowing when to make a cut towards the rim. Him and Cole Anthony have a really good connection when Anthony is operating as the ball handler and Wagner as the cutter. Wagner is such a good cutter, in fact, that he literally has not missed a single shot off of a cut this year. He is shooting 100% from the field on cuts. This is the result of just making intelligent movements away from the ball to give yourself an easy shot at the rim. One thing, in my opinion, that can take a player from that lower level fringe all-star to being able to score with ease is the ability to draw fouls. One very fortunate aspect of Wagner's game is the fact that he's a fantastic free throw shooter, around 84% this season. If he can work on his ability to draw fouls, that's going to take him to the next level, because then not only can he get to the line when he needs to, but defenses are also going to have to be careful when guarding him, allowing him more space to score. As far as his jump shooting goes, there's a lot to like, albeit there are some areas that he needs to improve on, which I'm going to get into. But his catch and shoot game is really nice. He's shooting 40% on catch and shoot threes this year, and I'm going to slow down a couple clips of his shot form. It is really nice and just super smooth. He's great at getting into his shooting motion immediately after receiving the ball, and his shot form is just super fluid. I'm going to be honest, I absolutely just love his shooting form. He has by far one of the cleanest jump shots I've seen from a rookie in a really long time. One thing that's really going to give him an advantage is his 7-foot wingspan. This is roughly what the recipe for a potential star looks like. Solid fundamentals, tight ball handling ability, an advantageous frame, which Wagner has at 6'10 with a 7-foot wingspan. And he has at least some level of athletic ability, as we've seen. A lot of people have compared him to Gordon Hayward, which may seem funny because they're both white small forwards, but it's honestly not entirely inaccurate. I think Hayward offers a little bit more playmaking and defense than Wagner is currently capable of, but their scoring profiles aren't all that dissimilar, and I definitely think that Wagner can implement some better defense and playmaking ability into his game. So what is the ceiling for Wagner? I may be higher on him than some people are, but I think he has all the tools to become a star. He's got this super special frame, he's got really, really solid ball handling ability, a really clean shot form, and he has all the tools necessary to become a threatening three-level scorer. The Magic need a franchise guy, and whether it's Cole Anthony or Franz Wagner, I think both of these guys are fully capable of taking the jump to make the Orlando Magic competitive again. So what do you think Franz Wagner's ceiling is? Be sure to let me know in the comments below, and as always, if you guys are new to the channel, why not hit that subscribe button if you enjoyed the video? We are almost to 4,000 subscribers, so let's try to hit that by the end of the year. As always, don't forget to leave a like on the video, because that is the number one way to help me out with the YouTube algorithm and get this video recommended to more people. Thank you guys so much for an amazing 2021. My goal was to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, and we blew that out of the water. It really does blow my mind, and I cannot express my gratitude enough. All that being said, I'm really excited for 2022. Let me know what you guys want to see in this new year. Again, thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks.